Jeffrey Archer's first novel, Not a Penny More, Not a Penny Less, is a page-turning tale of fraud, revenge and determination as four investors stop at nothing to get back what was stolen from them. The four investors came together and shadow their accuser from the casinos of Monte Carlo to the high-stakes windows at Ascot and the hallowed lawns of Oxford. Their plan is simple. To sting the crook for exactly what they lost, not a penny more, not a penny less. This is another of Jeffrey's tales with just a little twist. I used this as part of my holiday reading on the new Kindle Paperwhite my husband bought me from PC World. Like most of his other stories, I couldn't put it down. By the way, I love the Kindle as well. It is lighter than either of the tablets I have owned and is readable in the full sun. My other half was taking to a couple we had met in a bar and the lady had one and recommended it. Glad he got it for me, lighter than the tablet and easier to read than either the tablet and the phone. Brilliant. Quite another extremely well-written and constructed novel by Jeffrey Archer. Had read this book quite a number of years ago and at the time I was really impressed by its plot. Saw it again for sale and decided to read it again since I had forgotten the complex plot. Certainly not disappointed second time around, and my husband is currently reading the book again. Would certainly recommend it to anyone who still hasn't come across it. Absolutely brilliant story. How on earth Jeffrey Archer comes up with such intriguing plots, heaven only knows. Certainly highly recommend. What a wonderful story, I'd recommend it to anyone. It is gripping and has a vein of humor running through it. I came to Jeffrey Archer quite late in my life, although I knew he'd written some books but somehow thought I wouldn't like them. How wrong I was. Now I can't get enough of them. This one in particular is so well written that you feel you know the characters, and what a collection they are, especially the one who keeps them on the straight and narrow. It's better for you to read the synopsis than for me to tell you what the story's about, but I don't think you'll be disappointed if you buy this. Brilliantly written, not my normal type of book like thrillers but kept me reading more, Prisoner of Birth is tops too. This is another very well written by the master of book writing. It is a simple story about two chaps who view life very differently, and who wish to compete with one another although they both don't know it. A compelling read with a very good ending. Enjoyed this book quite a lot. The story is a bit far-fetched, but I think that this have been the beauty of it. Well worth a read and a bit of a laugh. Great read, just started reading books from this author, normally like crime thrillers books, but he has got me hooked. Love his storytelling. I laughed all through it all over again after a repeat reading this fantastic book after a period of 15 years, or more, I'm not sure, and have no regrets in losing two earlier copies which have not come back to after being lent to friends. Let everyone who gets hold of this book enjoy it. Absolutely brilliant story from start to finish as usual. You couldn't imagine the surprise, and especially coming before the end of the book. This is the second time of my reading this book, and second time around it was even better. It is pure entertainment. I wouldn't have picked a Jeffrey Archer book, but a good friend recommended him as an excellent storyteller. I figured millions of others had made him a bestseller, so I should give one a try. I'm glad I did. Archer spins an excellent yarn. It's the kind of book I wanted to get back to. I've also now read Cain and Abel. I will read others, I'm sure. In his usual magnificent style, Jeffrey Archer has captivated me yet again with his ability to write a great story. His intelligent and creative storyline never lets you down. The twist at the end is clever, and his characters original and credible. I thoroughly enjoyed this book and would recommend it to all ages and stages of readers, as his writing is easy to read, engaging to the end and beautifully crafted. Great book, was hooked from start to finish. Read the Clifton Chronicles recently, and enjoyed them so much I decided to read another of Jeffrey Archer's books. I certainly wasn't disappointed. I love this story. A light-hearted tale of revenge on a greedy Wall Street crook. My only gripe is that it was a rather short tale. Please, a sequel with Harvey Metcalf getting even. The final sentence of this book caused me to actually laugh out loud. Such a fun read and not at all like any of Archer's other books. Highly recommend this one about four men being conned, and getting their revenge by conning the con man. Loved it. This swindle of the decade became the sting of the century. Click link in description for more reviews.